Here, observe that we are currently discussing. Sorry, we are currently discussing about JavaScript. Regarding currently, we are talking for the last 4 or 5 days. For the last four or five days. So we are currently JavaScript. JavaScript we are currently for the last 4 or 5 days. Here, if you observe, sir, we covered what we call data types. Next and after that, what about functions are important methods? Next, sir, what about how to write functions? Like we covered all these things, right? Okay, we discussed all these things we covered already, right? Okay, so now I have one small important point you people should aware, sir. So just one point you should aware, at the part of JavaScript, we are always going to talk about only JavaScript. We are always going to talk about only JavaScript, sir. JavaScript only. We are not going to talk with respect to, do you know, right? We never going to talk about with respect to something like we are not going to discuss with respect to something like HTML, CSS, and so on. Sir, I want to use JavaScript with the HTML and the CSS. Some concept must be required. That concept is nothing but DOM. That is our next topic anyway. Don't worry, while discussing JavaScript, sir, you are not using any HTML and CSS like, no. We are just talking about JavaScript language level. Next, how you can use this JavaScript to communicate with HTML, to communicate with the CSS, then we can go for DOM concept, right? Now, have a look once, sir, in my example. Here, this is my demo.html. Are you getting demo.html like this we have, sir? Sir, do you know, here, very, very simple, sir. Very simple. Let me comment the script. Let me comment the script, sir. Here, observe. If I open this code, just to get the basic idea what we are going to learn at the part of this. Okay. Now, if you consider that, just observe. It's very simple, sir. It's very, very simple. What is this one, sir? H1 tag. Next and after that, what is this one? One paragraph. Next, favorite food. Next one, unordered list. Sir, chicken, mutton, fish, any animal, including human being also. Favorite food, favorite drink, kingfisher, knockout, milk and thumbs up also. Like view profile, like we have. Are getting a small HTML page I have, sir. I have. Now, I want to write some JavaScript code. Now observe that. Sir, here I'm taking something right. Can I use the word? It is a JavaScript function or not? Can you please confirm? Is it a JavaScript function or not? Yes, it is also JavaScript variables and so on. Here one special word I'm always using, keep on document, like this thing is nothing but DOM, document object model, DOM we are using, sir. Just have a look once. What it is doing here, let me remove that comment. If I remove that comment, now it will be applicable, right? Let me remove that comment. Now observe that. If you are seeing, do you know, sir, this one H1 tag, paragraph tag, H2 tag, and then H2 tag, and then what is this? This one is, sir, like another automatically, do you know, sir, keep on changing the colors, random colors. You never going to see random colors. All the colors by default is going to be considered, sir, because random color function I wrote on my own. Okay, like, are you getting right? Sir, it is the simple HTML, sir, HTML, but I wrote JavaScript. That JavaScript is going to create these effects. Sir, if you want JavaScript to communicate with HTML or to communicate with CSS, the next level concept is something like, what is that next level concept, sir? Itself is nothing but, yes, anyone is DOM. DOM is the concept, sir, what we require to you. JavaScript, and then JavaScript, and then HTML, CSS in the middle, one broker must be required, one person must be required, one interface must be required. That interface itself is nothing but DOM concept. Don't worry, sir. As of now, while discussing this concept, JavaScript functionality, talk about only JavaScript. Later, we will think about how you can use this JavaScript with respect to HTML and CSS. That is our next concept. Clear for all of you, right? Sir, don't worry. Sir is telling only JavaScript just like a language. He's not using with HTML. He's not using with the CSS. Like, don't feel that. That's what my intention of telling this example, right? Clear? Are you able to understand? Okay, like, sir, it's keep on changing the colors. So don't worry, sir, which color is going to come? Sir, all the four colors are different. Which color is going to come? We don't know that. In the world, all possible colors by default is going to be generated, sir. Because random function, I wrote like that. Are you getting? Random function, I wrote like that. 0 to 9, A to F, it is always going to pick some random letters. And with that random color is going to be generated, return that random color. But how, what combination is going to come? We don't know that. It's keep on generating only. Okay, like somewhere, am I using this function? Anyone remember that? This function, last function. Anyone remember that? Yo, where is the last function? Someone, we used it here. Have you remembered, right? Set interval like this, somewhere we covered yesterday only we discussed it, right? Higher order function, a function can take another function as the argument. Set interval function, what it's always going to do, it will take a function. This function will be called for every 1000 milliseconds, for every 1 second, keep on executing like that. It is going to be there, sir. 1 millisecond means 1000 milliseconds means 1 second. 1 second for every second, this change color by default is going to be executed like that. Clear, right? Okay, that's all. Okay, this is what you people should aware clearly, right? Okay, that's all, sir. 1 minute, the people, there are some people who are very much interested about this code. Just no, it's not going to be yeah, just it's not, don't worry, just we will discuss, don't worry about that. Yeah, that's all. Just this example I will explain color changer application. Just remind once, even by mistake if I forgot, mostly I won't forget. Okay, now in the today's session, what is the topic we are going to discuss? Right, sir? Erase concept and then objects concept. These are the only two topics which are pending in JavaScript language level, at very top level, right? Okay, sir, now first I will talk about arrays and then I will talk about objects. Both are data structures to hold a group of values. Can you please tell what is an array? Array is nothing but, can you please tell what is an array? Array is a group of values. Regarding array itself is a group of values. An index collection of elements. An index collection of elements. Collection of elements. Correct or not? An index collection of elements, right? So do you know, here I have one small doubt. What is the advantage of arrays concept, right? Just a matter of 1 minute, the people who don't know about programming, just aware. What the purpose of arrays concept is, suppose I want, if I'm taking where n1 is equal to 10, sir. Can you please tell what I'm doing? I'm taking one variable n1 to represent the value 10. Correct or not? I'm taking a variable n1 to represent value 10. Suppose my requirement is I want to represent two values where n2 is equal to 20. Where n2 is equal to 20. Like this I'm taking, sir. If I can take where n2 is equal to 20. Sir, how many variables I'm taking total? Please guide. How many variables I'm taking total? Two variable. How many values we are representing? Two values we are representing, right? Sir, now my question is third variable we are going to discuss. Okay, now where n3 is equal to like 3. Sir, to hold the three values, three variables are required. To hold the 1000 values, then never recommended to take 1000 variables like this. Are you getting that? Never recommended to take 1000 variable n1, n2, n3, n4, n1000, like not recommended. All these values we have to group. All these values we have to group inside a single variable. That group of elements is nothing but arrays concept. Remember that, sir. How you can take where numbers is equal to 10, 20, 30, 40, like that. Happily you can able to take 10, 20, 30, 40, like this. Happily you can able to take, sir. Now, sir, how you can able to print? How you can able to access? We can able to access by using you can able to access by using sir index. Are you getting? We can able to access by using index. Index of 10, 0. Index of 20, 1, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. By using index, we can able to take. I hope you people can able to understand. Can you please tell what is the biggest advantage of arrays concept? Please respond by seeing these two scenarios. Scenario 1, scenario 2. Scenario 1, scenario 2. What is the biggest advantage of arrays concept? So we are not required to declare multiple variables. Even multiple values you can able to represent by using single variable. By using single variable. That's why readability. That's why readability. Readability of the code by default is going to be improved, sir. Readability by default is going to be improved. Length of the code is going to be reduced like anything. That's all. That is the biggest advantage of arrays concept, right? Whether it is the Java, whether it is almost all everywhere we are going for collections concept is nothing but yes, the biggest advantage. Length of we are going to reduce. Next, more flexibility by default we are going to get. Next, let me use one small example and then we will talk about next level terminology, right? But here there are some important loopholes are there. Those things I will discuss for you people, right? Just observe a bit very, very carefully about this one. Sir, here I'm trying to open. 1 minute. Let me take another example. Otherwise, your concentration is always with these colors on JavaScript. Okay, normal example I'm taking. Sir, here let me open the browser. Browser like this I'm taking. Sir, anyway, don't worry. There are no colors and so on. Just here I'm taking like this. Sir, just what we can control L clear, sir. Okay, that's all. Here this is about my console. Now my question is, observe. I want to take sir one array. Have you observed one ruffle? Sir, 1 minute. Have you observed right? Where friends? Can I use the word? Is it array or not? Yes, sir. Durga, Sunny, Bunny, Chinny. Is nothing but one array I created, right? Correct or not? Okay. Is it valid or not? Yes, valid, no problem at all. Sir, I want to get the first element. First element I want to get the console.log of. Okay. Sir, now friends of 0 I'm asking. Can you please tell what is the output by default we are going to get, sir? Durga. Obviously, console.log of friends of 0 is nothing but like a 0. Now I'm taking 1, sir. What is the answer by default we are going to get? Yes, sir, Sunny. Like this, right? Now, I have one very, very important point, sir. Very important point. Now I'm taking friends of 100. 100. What is the output by default we will get now? Console.log of friends of 100. 100. What is the output by default we are going to get? Very simple, sir. Very simple. Sir, in the case of JavaScript arrays, we never going to get array index out of bounds exception. We never going to get array index out of bounds exception. Simply, it is going to tell undefined. Regarding simply, it is going to tell undefined. Boss, that value is not there. Simply, it's going to tell that undefined. Remember that, sir. Remember, most of the people are going to fail. Sir, if you are trying to access out of range index, then in Python, I'm getting index error. In Java, I'm getting array index out of bounds exception, but in JavaScript, you never going to get any index error or array index out of bounds exception. Simply, the result by default you are going to get, okay, just undefined. That's it. Any doubt? Please respond. Any doubt about this one? Okay, well, next, one more point you have to aware. Sir, I want to modify the content. What I want to take is friends of one is equal to actually friends of one, which value is there? Can you please respond? Which value is there, Sunny? I want to replace Sunny with Malika. Okay, no problem at all. Yes, it is replaced, sir. Let me print console.log of friends. Like this I'm talking about, sir. Friends, like I'm talking. What is the output by default we are going to get? Durga, Mallika, Sunny gone. Now Mallika is there, right? Are you getting? Mallika is there. Like, sir, what it means? Observe a bit very, very carefully about this one. So what it means? Arrays, yes, you can change the content. Even in the case of normal array also. happily you are allowed to change the content, sir. Even in Java, Java is always there, acceptable, right? Yes, you can able to do that. So updating array elements possible or not? Yes, it is possible. So how to access array elements? How to access array elements? How to access array elements with the index by using index. But one good news, we never going to get array index out of bounds exception or index error. Okay, well, next, how to modify, how to update array elements, how to modify or replace array elements like just by using okay, like this, sir, just index only friends of one is a nothing but just some mallika like this. I'm taking, sir, 100% pakka, this one is the valid code, no problem at all. Friends of one itself is mallika like this, acceptable, right? Now I have one small doubt. Listen very carefully, this is the point I'm waiting to tell, this point only, right? Can you please tell, once we create an array, the size is always fixed or not? Can you please respond? Once we create an array, the size is always fixed or not? Can you please? Is it possible to add new elements? New elements? No chance at all. Because array's concept problem. To overcome this problem only, we should go for collections concept in Java. The people who are coming from collections background, to overcome this problem only, we should go for collections concept in Java, right? Okay, like array list, linked list, like that. So now I want to add a new element. I'm trying to adding a new element to the array. One minute. Observe a bit carefully, sir. Sir, already friends of 0, 1, 2, 3 is there. 0, 1, 2, 3 is there. Means 4 elements are there, sir. Now, friends of 0, 1, 2, 3 is there. Friends of 4 is equal to just any name. Okay, friends of 4 is equal to some katana. Like this, I'm adding. Can you please guide? Is it valid or is it invalid? That's what I'm expecting from you people. Yeah, maybe. Can you please guess? Even you don't know. If you don't know also, no problem at all. Guess something. Is it valid or is it invalid? 100% pakka. 100% pakka. This one is. 100% pakka. This one is. Okay? Remember, this is one doubt. This is one doubt. Second doubt, I didn't cover the answer. Second doubt is, arrays, have you observed two arrays I took? Here I took only numbers. Next, here I took only string objects. Here I took only string objects like this, right? Only strings. Can you please tell, is it possible to add heterogeneous elements or not? Is it possible to add heterogeneous? What's the meaning of heterogeneous, man? Different type of object. One is number, second one is the string, like that. Different type of things allowed or not allowed. Okay. These are two points you people should aware, sir. Yes, array is always fixed in size. Array is always meant for a homogeneous elements only, like this, right? Okay, array is always meant for a homogeneous elements only. Array is always fixed in size. If really it is array concept, these are the things you should aware. But in JavaScript, arrays concept is something like a collection only. They use some wrong terminology, it seems, when compared with other languages, right? Instead of array, if they are using list, it will be too good. But anyway, they use array only. Sir, JavaScript arrays concept is nothing but our list concept. Remember, list can take heterogeneous elements. List can be growable. If you want, you can add elements, you can remove elements. All those things are possible. So JavaScript arrays concept is not really arrays concept. In other languages, it is considered as a list concept. Any doubt? Are you in the position to understand this one? Now, can you please tell, is it possible or not? With my explanation, I hope you can able to understand. Yes, sir. collections are no more. Collections means erase and objects only. Remember that. Erase and objects only. Collections means there is no separate collections concept. Whatever erase concept we are discussing is one collection. Next, objects like one more concept we are going to discuss next. It is also another collection. That's all. Okay. Is it valid or not? 100% pakka itself is valid, sir. Don't worry about that. 100% pakka itself is valid. Just let me take friends. Friends, I'm taking what the outputs are. Four elements are there. Now, let me copy paste. Here, friends of four is equal to Katrina. Like this, I'm taking, sir. Katrina like. Now, let me print friends. Yes, Katrina came or not? Are Katrina came or not? Yes, perfectly, sir. Next, it's the two worst. It's the two worst friends of 20. Friends of 20 is equal to Karina. Like this, I'm taking. Can you please tell? Is it valid or not? Malaya, heterogeneous objects, no problem at all. Is it valid or not? Ayo. Is it valid or not? Yes or no? Yes or no? Okay. Remember that. Is it valid or invalid? The problem here is, the problem here is, do you know only 0 to 4 elements, 5 elements only? But now you are asking about 20th index. 20th index, 100% pakka. It is, it is valid or invalid? 100% pakka. It is, ayo, valid or invalid? Oh, Katrina and Karina are enemies, so invalid, like, oh, no. Okay, 100% pakka itself is valid, no problem at all. It is going to be added in the 20th index only. No issue at all. It will be added in the 20th index only. Then immediately you ask, sir, what about 5th index, 6th index, 7th index, and the 20th index? All the remaining filled with empty. Valid, sir. Valid. Now, if you want, you can just print that. Can you please observe that? Total 21 elements are there. Total 21 elements are there. Okay. First 5 elements. And then, how many empty cells are there in the middle? Can you please observe? I hope you can able to see. Can you please observe? How many empty cells are there in the middle? 15 empty cells are there. At last, after 15 empty cells, Karina came in the picture. Two worst. Are you getting that? Okay. Empty. Empty means nothing. Nothing is there. Not null, nothing is there, something like that. Are you getting right? Nothing, maybe undefined or something like that, nothing. Clear? Any doubt about this one? Are you able to understand? Yes. So, here, yes, obviously, that's what I'm telling, that growable, based on our requirement, you can increase the size, you can decrease the size, all the possibilities are there. This is what they choose, the wrong word, erase. Actually, it is the concept of array, collections concept or list concept. They have to use the word. Yes, memory will be wasted. That's why no one is going to add this element at the 20th. We require to add at last only. For that, ready-made methods are there. No one is going to do like this, right? Observe that. No one is going to do like this one. Remember that, okay? So there are some methods are there. By using those methods, we require to add at last position. Last position. There is a, yes, we can able to do. It will be empty. Malaya, it will be empty. Like I will show. Don't worry about that. It will be empty or otherwise adjusted that memory, middle memory. Maybe we will discuss. Don't worry with the example. Up to this is the clear, right? So based on our requirement, you can increase the size, you can decrease the size. Next, while increasing by index, sir, how you can able to add elements, update elements, and so on, you people should be aware. Sir, index will play very important role. By using index, you can retrieve the value. By using index, you can update the value. By using index, you can add elements. By using index, you can add elements. So everything is nothing but index. Index based arrays concept, right? Okay, like that. Next, I want to create empty array. I want to create empty array, sir. Very simple. Where nums is equal to empty, like this. Just the bracket open, bracket close. That's all. Itself is nothing but empty array. Empty array, something like empty list. empty list in our Python, something like empty array, you can able to create. There is another way is also there, sir, but most of the people are not going to use new array. It is also one way, sir. It is also one way. So if you want to create an empty array, you can choose either this way or you can choose either this way, no problem at all. Anything is acceptable. Anything itself is acceptable. How you can create an empty array, right? Next, I want to find the what is the length of, how to find the length of, how to find the length, length, length of the array. Very simple, sir. Can you please tell what is the way? What is the way? Sir, this array is having length of variable is there, sir. Length of variable is there. Sir, nums is an array. Then you can ask nums.length, nums.length, nums.length. Okay, are you getting? You already we saw friends, friends.length. Then automatically it's going to tell how many number of elements are there. Sir, name of the array, dot length. Name of the array, dot length, dot length. Then how many number of arrays are there? By default, it's going to be do that. Clear, right? Are you getting? Yeah, Vinod Kumar. Converting directly is not there, but we can able to read one by one, and then you can able to add to the array. Okay, like that. So how to find the length? By using length variable is there, sir. Remember that. Next, is a JavaScript array can hold random elements or not? Is the JavaScript array can hold random element or not? Yes, what is the way, sir? Yes, it is hold what we call heterogeneous elements or not. Yes, man. Happily, it's allowed to hold heterogeneous elements, no problem at all. Now, let me consider that where here, just I'm taking where just a random collection. Can you please observe that? Where random collection? Durga, 10,000, true, null. Durga, 10,000. What about this one? First one? First one is the string type. Second one is the number type. Third one is the Boolean type. Fourth one is the null. Null. Yes, I'm taking, sir. Now, let me print the random collection. Yes, Durga, 10,000. True, null. By default, we are getting. So, arrays, JavaScript arrays can hold. JavaScript arrays can hold, okay, heterogeneous elements also. Remember. Next, random collection. Random collection dot length. Random collection dot length. Then automatically, how many elements are there? Four elements are there. That's why four by default we are going to get. Any doubt? Next, Nandakishore, how you can able to create empty array? Either this style or this style, both are the same. No difference at all internally. Yes, we are creating object explicitly. This is the shorthand notation. The people are always going to use this approach. But whenever even you are taking like this, internally, this one is going to be happen. Okay? Sir, that's all. Now, everyone got basic idea. If you want to hold a group of heterogeneous elements, index based, then we should go for arrays concept. Okay, based on our requirement, arrays, you can, based on our requirement, you can add elements, you can remove elements, all the things are possible. Heterogeneous elements are available, heterogeneous elements are possible. Next, length is not fixed. Sir, based on our requirement, you can change its length, no problem at all. We can update the values, we can remove the values, we can add new elements, like all the things by default possible. Next, index error, such type of terminology is not applicable here. Okay, full flexible thing itself is like this, right? Okay, like that. Rashekar, it is invalid because the reason for that is we are not going to specify the type because it is a dynamically typed language. That's why any variable we have to take with where only. Where x is equal to, we are not required to specify the type because the reason is automatically based on your provided type, that type will be considered new array. Automatically it will be considered based on, because you are creator of array type, like that it is going to consider, don't worry. Okay, but here you should not use array. Do you know the people who are java people? In java 10 onwards this type of facility came in java 10 for local variables. Yes, so this type of facility came in java 10 for local variables. Okay, nothing, just slowly the java people Malaya, where are you, man? Java 10 released, very soon java 11 also going to come. Okay. Now here, this is what is array. Just what is the array? important conclusions I hope it's very clear. Okay, can you just heterogeneous objects are allowed or not? Heterogeneous or not? Can you please tell? Heterogeneous objects are allowed or not? Yes, heterogeneous objects are allowed. Next, is it mutable or immutable? Can I able to change the content? Can I able to change the content? Mutable or immutable? Mutable. Next, based on my requirement, can I increase and decrease? Is it dynamic or not? Is it dynamic or not? Dynamic means growable or not. Based on our requirement, you can increase, you can decrease, no problem at all. Next, how you can access array elements by using? How you can access array elements by using index? Index. How to find the number of elements present inside array? How to find number of elements present inside array by using length variable? These are various length variable. Number of elements present inside array, length variable. These are the things what you people should aware about the just the general discussion about arrays concept, right? JavaScript arrays concept. Now the next thing what I want to discuss is important methods related to JavaScript arrays, right? Important methods related to JavaScript arrays. What methods are there? Main important methods, right? Just there are several methods are there which are applicable on arrays. Sir, just you can use these methods directly. We are not required to implement this because it's a collection related methods. So there are several methods. Ready-madely, happily we are allowed to use, no problem at all, sir. Now the point here is just the six important methods I'm going to discuss. Sir, all these methods very easy to remember, easy to understand. Nothing is there. Sir, what is the first method? Push method. Obviously, what is the second method? If the first method is the push, what is the second method? Second method, pop is the method. Are you getting? Pop is the method. Next, third one, sir, unshift is the next method, sir. Unshift. If it's the unshift, automatically, what is the fourth method? What is the fourth method? Shift is the fourth method. Next, sir, what is the index of? Oi, what is the index of so-and-so element? Index of, what is the index? Index of so and so element, like this, right? Index of. Next one after that, can you please tell slice? In Python, you have slicing is there, right? Slice operator is there, right? That slice operator, here slice method, it is available. Beyond that, nothing. It's a slice is a method. Method itself is available, right? Okay. Now, sir, what is the difference between, what push, pop, unshift, and so on, right? Very simple, very easily you can able to understand. Nothing will be there, sir. Nothing will be there. Let me talk about first one, push method. Push. Can you please tell push method to add or to remove? Please respond. To add or to remove? To add an element. To add an element. Element. Where? Is it going to add in the last position or is it going to add in the first position? Is it going to add in the last or first? By default, it's always going to add element at the last position. Are you getting? That's why we are not required to worry about what is the length and so on. Automatically, we are not required to worry about length. Automatically, just call push, it will be added at last. It will be added at last, okay? So the memory won't be wasted. Are you getting? Like earlier, we saw 15 cells are empty. Such type of memory wastage won't be there, sir. Okay, remember, here I'm taking where numbers, here just observe that, where numbers is equal to 10, 20, 30, 40. 40 I'm taking, sir. That's all. Now, numbers dot, sir, what is that? Push I'm taking, sir. Numbers dot, push I'm taking. Sir, how you can able to, just let me add 50, like this I'm trying to add, sir. Yes, added. At the which total now added right. Let me print what about numbers value 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Automatically, it will be added in the last position or not? Respond, it will be added in the last position or not? Okay, yes. After adding, sir, what is going to return? If you observe the number of elements, length by default is going to return, sir. Numbers are not push up 50, it will add the element in the last position and the returns number of elements like this, right? Clear? This is about push is the method. Number of elements, it is not index. Number of elements like this, right? Sir, next, this is the push method. Obviously, can you please tell what is the second one? Pop. Can you please tell what is the pop, sir? Pop method to remove and return, to remove and return last element. Okay, to remove and return last element. Last element, right? Okay, sir. Like now, can you please numbers dot pop, numbers dot pop, that's all. Pop, what it's going to do, last element by default will be removed, sir. Now, if you want, let me print numbers 10, 20, 30, 40. Let me print numbers 10, 20, 30, 40 by default. We are going to get again. Let me use numbers dot pop. Yes. Can you please tell now which element by default will be removed, sir? Yes, which element by default will be removed, sir? 40 by default will be removed. 40 by default will be removed, right? Removed. Okay. Print, if you print numbers 10, 20, 30 by default, are you getting to remove and return last element? Last element, then automatically we require to use pop is the method. Of course, this pop may not take arguments. It's not going to take arguments, but in Python, pop is going to take argument also. Okay, like, sir, any doubt about this one? Any doubt about these two methods? Nothing, right? Everyone can able to understand. Array, can you please add in the last position? Can you please remove the last element? If you want to add in the last position, if you want to remove the last element, then automatically, up to these, how many methods we covered? Please respond. Up to these, how many methods we covered? Two methods. What is the first one? Push and pop. No. We covered all the four methods. Four methods already covered. What is the reason? Yes, sir. Push and pop always talks about last element. Hey, can you please add in the last position? Can you please remove the last element? Unshift and shift. Are you getting? Unshift and shift. Both are exactly same as push and pop only. Push and pop only. What is the difference? Yes, these two always talks about first position. Hey, can you please add in the first position? Unshift is like push, except that it will add in first. Are you getting? It will add in the first instead of last. First shift means is like a pop. Observe that pop. That's why I'm covering unshift first and then shift. Most of the times we are going to shift and unshift, but I'm using the word unshift. Unshift is like push operation, shift is like a pop operation. Okay, like you people should aware, sir. You can add at the beginning or you can add at the last. Okay, now observe the numbers dot unshift. I'm taking unshift of 777. I'm taking. Can you please tell where it will be added? Where it will be added, sir? 777 I'm taking. Numbers dot unshift of 777. Where it will be added? In the starting position. Numbers, right? What is the answer? Yes, 777 came in the beginning or not? Yes, 777 perfectly is coming in the beginning, sir. No problem at all. Similarly, I'm taking numbers dot unshift. Similar or otherwise, unshift of some 999 I'm taking, sir. Now again it will be added in the first position. Now if you can ask numbers, sir, 999, 777, 10, 20, 30 by default we are going to get. Yes, perfectly itself is valid, sir. Now what I'm taking, sir, numbers like, yes sir, this is about my current content. Boss, can you please remove first element? What the method we require to call? Numbers dot shift operation. Shift, that's all. It won't take any argument, sir. Shift, it won't take any argument. 999 by default gone. 999 by default gone. Can you please print numbers, right? Can you please print numbers? Numbers like here I'm taking numbers. But the outputs are 777, 10, 20, 30 because 999 by default gone. 999 by default gone. Clear, right? Unshift operation means to add element in the first operation means to remove element from the first position. Next, push and pop always talks about last element position, last elements. Next, unshift and shift always talks about first element's position. So, total four methods are covered. Any doubt? Yeah. maybe Rajshekhar Reddy, there is no such type of method or something like it. May tell. Clear, right? Yes, I want to show the return element. Yes, man. Yes, sir. Here have you observed, right? It is removing. Suppose assume that I want to show the removed element. I want to show the removed element here. Maybe console dot log of console dot log of numbers dot pop. I'm taking. Can you please tell which element will be removed? Which element will be removed? Pop. I'm using. Can you tell which element will be removed? Sir, 30. Now observe that 30. Am I printing 30 or not? Yes. Okay. Same cases like that. Okay, like Padmaraj. Suppose here just employees. I want to represent all employee objects. I want to represent all employee objects. So if I want to add a new employee, then obviously push the method. If you want to remove an employee, then automatically, do you know? We require to use pop operation, something like wherever your group of objects are there, if you want to add something, if you want to remove, it's a very common operations. Like I want to send a SMS message for all mobile numbers. I have to store all mobile numbers somewhere. Better to go for erase concept. I want to pick each number and I have to send SMS. Then you have to choose either shift operation or you can use either pop operation. Getting Padmaraj? Yeah. Nothing. Just I'm using to print that value. It is going to return that value. Return value we are getting, right? Removing particular index element is possible or not? I'm not sure. Maybe. Just 1 minute. Pop off here numbers dot. Numbers I'm taking currently 777 1020. 1 minute, sir. Maybe I never checked because just important methods only. Just I prepared, sir. Numbers dot pop off 012. One I'm taking. Yes, numbers dot pop off 1 I'm taking. Even you are taking 1 also. Which element by default are removed, sir? Taking one argument also, it is taking last. What it means, man? Numbers dot pop off 2 I'm taking. You can pass. My style is always fixed. I will remove only last element only. I will remove only last element, that's all. Okay, you can pass any value, it seems. Yeah. Next, if I can take numbers dot pop off 1 minute, sir. 1 minute, sir. Let me reinitialize the value. Numbers is equal to 10 comma 20 comma 10 comma 20 comma 30 comma 40. Like this I'm taking, sir. Now numbers dot pop. Okay, some 20 I want to remove. Okay. Have you observed? Now some 20 I want to remove. Sorry, it is always going to remove last element only. Okay, like 10, 20, 30. So, it is Basha and voice. Okay, yeah, it is not listening. Correct. Yeah, are you able to understand that? Anyway, we are not going to do some research and seek idea is enough. Don't worry, sir. If you want, just we can explore all the methods. Do you know? Maybe. Do you know? In the Google, there is a MDN is there. Do you know what is that MDN? MDN, sir? Anyone? Sir, do you know if you want the front end kind of things, front end kind of things, if you want, then automatically two websites are very popular, sir. What is the first one? W3 schools, HTML, Java. What is an array? Next and after that, here, general knowledge. You are me. No. Okay, here just what I will do is I will ask Google only. Too good. MDN arrays. Yeah. JavaScript arrays. MDN JavaScript arrays. Yes, can you please observe that? Yes, beautiful. Yeah, sir, here just observe a bit carefully. Array dot length, array dot methods from is array, observe off, like there are several methods are there. Pop method, like there are several methods are there. Properties, this is the function related line. Sir, just go through that the people who require. Just go through that the people who require arrays concept, right? Remove an item by index position. Have you observed? Here just what is the thing we require to take, sir? Splice is the method. Regarding splice is the method from by index position. What is the method? Even in our one example, we are going to use this method, sir. Splice is the method. Next, find the index of an item. Yes, index of. Next, add to the front of the array, unshift operation. Remove from the front of the array, shift operation. Okay, at the end of the array, add, remove, and so on. Loop over the array. Like happily, just you can go through this one, sir. The basic idea, that's all. We are not required to worry much about that. Okay, that's it. Now, sir, up to this, any doubt? Push, pop, unshift, undershift operations. Any doubt? Any doubt about this one? Okay, well, what is the next one? This also, we are not required to worry much about that. Very simple, sir. Index, yeah. One small doubt one student is keep on asking. Sir, just take a bit very, very special care. What it means, what the doubt is, sir, duplicates are allowed or not allowed? Same element can be repeated or not? Yes, it can be repeated. Duplicates are allowed. Sir, if I use index of to find index of specified element, if the element present multiple times, then this method is always going to return first occurrence. Remember that if the specified element present multiple times, then it's always going to return sir first occurrence index. If the specified element is not available, then simply we are going to get -1. Remember that if it is not available, then simply we are going to get -1, like this, right, sir? Just observe a bit carefully, sir. Here I'm taking just 1 minute. here I'm taking, sir, where element happily we can go for this attribute, right? Remember index of method. Clear? It's already known thing in our programming, right? Okay, last method, slice. Sir, what is the purpose of this slice method? Is we can use a slice to get part of the array, correct, right? Yeah, to get part of the array. Slice means what? One piece. Sir, in this array, can you please provide, sir, only third index to fifth index elements or 10th index to 20th index elements, like you can able to talk. Okay, sir, there are two versions of slice. Slice means what? Piece, a small piece, right? A small piece itself is slice operator, right, into pieces. Like, now my requirement is I have some numbers are there. I want from 1 to 5. Can you please provide? I want from 1 to 5, something like how you can able to do that. 1 minute, have a look once. Just I'm taking, I have where numbers is equal to 20, 30, 40, 50, 70, 80, like this I have. Num1 is equal to numbers dot slice of, sir, 2, 5. Begin and end. It returns. Do you know? It returns. There are, sir, we are passing two arguments. Begin, end. It returns, sir, from begin index to end -1 index. Remember this one, sir. Begin index to end -1 index. Like this, it is going to provide. Begin index to end -1, consider only that particular piece. Okay, remember that. Now have a look once where numbers like this I'm taking, sir. Where numbers like this I'm taking. Yes, perfect. Now I'm talking about 2 to 5. I'm talking about 2 to 5, sir. 2 to 5. Well, can you please tell what the 5, sir? 2 to 5. Well, can you please tell what the num1 contain? 0, 1, 2. 2 means what? 2 to 5. 2, 3, 4 only. 50, 30, 40, 50, 30, 40, 50, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, begin to n minus 1, begin to n minus 1, n minus 1. Have you observed? 30, 40, 50, by default we are going to get. Begin index to n minus 1 index. N is the 5, n minus 1 means 4, 2, 3, 4. Okay, like this we are going to get. Clear, right? Are you getting? Now, num2. Here just I'm taking, sir, where num2 is equal to, sir, numbers dot slice I'm taking, sir. Can you please tell what I'm going to get now? Numbers dot slice I'm taking, sir. What the answer by default you are going to get? Very simple. If you are not passing any values, if you are not passing anything, then it's always going to cut into last. Are you getting? Whole array by default, duplicate array by default you are going to get, sir. Now if you print num2, yes, all the elements by default will be there. Regarding total elements by default will be there. If you are passing values, then okay, there is a difference. You are not passing the values, then automatically complete array by default. Most of the times this thing can be used, this one can be used, do you know, yes, to create cloned copy. Regarding for cloning purpose, happily we are going to use this one, sir. Like next, multi, sir, that's all. This is a slice operator, right? Sir, up to this, any doubt? Everyone can able to understand, right? Push, pop, next and after that, unshift, shift, index of slice operator. Same as our programming languages like Python. There is no much difference, right? Sir, now, what's my next level requirement is, legend. Sometimes, array can contain array as elements, or inside array, we can take another array. Inside array, we can take another array. Such type of arrays are by default considered as nested arrays, multi-dimensional arrays, nested arrays, like that we can able to take, sir. Sir, how you can declare, how you can access? Mahesh, I don't think here step value. Some people are expecting, what about a step? Like 1 minute, numbers dot slice off, because we are coming from the Python, right? That's why 2, 7 I'm taking. From 2 to 7th index, step value 2 I'm taking. Because slice operator in Python, 3 arguments it's always going to take. 3 arguments it's always going to take. Sir, have you observed? 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 only. That argument, it is not going to consider. Are you getting? If really it is going to consider that argument, then obviously, what the answer? 30, 50, 70 I have to get. Because every second element I require to consider, but not consecutive, means step is not there. Next, nested arrays concept. What is the nested? Is equal to, just I'm taking, it's already array. In that first element, 10 comma 20 comma 30 is there, sir. Comma, sir, first element completed. Comma, next, 40 comma 50 comma 60 is there. 80 comma 90. 70 comma 80 comma 90 is there, sir. That's all. Sir, this is about where. Regarding this itself is nothing but where. Array of arrays concept. Array of arrays concept. Can I use the word? Is it valid or not? Is it meaningful or not? Yes, jagged arrays. We can use the word array of arrays concept. Array of arrays concept, or otherwise jagged arrays. If it is the .NET people, they are going to use the word jagged arrays, array of arrays concept. Okay, well, itself is acceptable, sir. Don't keep any doubt at all. 100% pakka itself is acceptable. Now my question is, okay, yeah, just it's going to be acceptable, sir. Yes, acceptable. How I can able to access, right? How I can able to access the elements? Very simple. Nums of 0. Zero I'm taking. Nums of 0. Of 0 I'm taking. Can you please guide what the answer? 0, 0. Nums of 0, 0. 0 means first element. In that again, 0 means first element. First element. Yes, its value is the 10. Perfectly, its value is the 10. Nums of 2 I'm taking. 2 I'm taking. Of 1 I'm taking. What the answer? Nums of 2, 1. Just like normal array concept. Second, 0, 1, 2 means third element in that. 1, okay, like 80 by default we are going to get. Observe that 2, 1 is nothing but 80 by default we are going to get. Any doubt? Suppose I'm taking nums of 1. Nums of 1, that's all. What the answer? Nums of 1, 40, 50, 60. Perfectly, 40, 50, 60. By default, we are going to get. Nums of 2, I'm taking, sir. Nums of 2 means which elements are 70, 80, 90, something like that. Yes, multi-dimensional arrays is also possible, no problem at all. Acceptable, sir. Clear? After this, that's all. Next, a small example I require to discuss. I'm going to use a book management application. I want to develop a small application, sir. Book management application. Sir, just a small, I want to add, I want to list the books, I want to exit the list, like we are going to do that. Okay, that part I will recommend it to start in the next session. But before that, yes, but before that, how to retrieve elements of the array? How you can able to retrieve elements of the array? Just we can retrieve elements of the array by using while loop, for each method. Are you getting that? What is that? While loop, for each method, Next, one more thing is there. For off is also available, sir. For off is also available. That part anyway, we will discuss. Sir, for off, there is for in is there. For off is also there. But for arrays, for off, but for objects, for in, remember that. Okay, we will discuss all these things. But one point you people should aware, arrays, this word is not that much really meaningful in JavaScript. Correct or not? The people who know Java, the people who know Python, the JavaScript people are misusing this word arrays. Correct, right? Because array is always, most of the people who are coming from programming languages like C language, Java language, everyone is always going to talk about, hey, fixed size, homogeneous element. Array means a fixed size, homogeneous elements like. But here, it is the, even they use the word arrays, something like list type. Remember that, correct. It is recommended to use the word list, one thing. Next, too much, worst word, the JavaScript people, I don't know that, why they choose that. After completing arrays concept, we are going to talk about objects concept. Are you getting? What is the next concept, sir? Objects concept. What did these objects mean, sir? Wow, two worst key value pairs, sir. Are you getting? Two key value pairs. Are you getting? Maps concept, sir. Maps concept are nothing but objects we are going to use. Wow. What terminology they use, man? Okay, dictionary is meaningful. Map meaningful. Are you getting? Map kind of thing meaningful, dictionary meaningful, hash meaningful, but they use the word objects. Okay, don't get confusion. Arrays is something like lists, objects are something like map concepts or dictionary dict concept, right? Is the objects concept. Okay, we will discuss these things almost around the, you have to spend two sessions. Okay, yeah, two sessions we are going to spend on this concept, right? Yeah, Vaishnav, maybe we will discuss. Okay, the two sessions for JavaScript, and then we will talk about next level DOM concept. Beautiful concept, sir. Okay, can I stop?